The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 9th, 1975, in Durban, South Africa.
Chapter 7, Knowledge of the Absolute. There are two things, absolute and the relative. This is relative world. Here we cannot understand one thing without the other. As soon as we speak that here is sun, there must be father. As soon as we say, here is husband, there must be wife. As soon as we say, here is servant, there must be master. As soon as we say, here is light, there must be darkness. This is called relative world. One has to be understood by other relative terms. But there is another world which is called absolute world. There the master and the servant the same. There is no distinction. Although one is master and other is servant, but the position is the same. So, the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita is giving us some hint about the absolute world, absolute knowledge. How that knowledge can be attained, that is being spoken by the absolute, supreme person, Krishna. Krishna is the Absolute Supreme Person. Ishara Parama Krishna. Satchidananda Vigraha. Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvakaram Karam. This is the definition of Krishna given by Lord Brahma in his book known as Brahma Samhita, very authorized book. This book was collected by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from southern India and he presented it to his devotees when he came back from southern India too. Therefore, we accept this book, Brahma Samhita, as very authoritative. This is our process of knowledge. We receive knowledge from the authority. Everyone receives knowledge from the authority. But general authority and our process of accepting authority is little different. Our process of accepting one authority means he is also accepting his previous authority. One cannot be authority self-made. That is not possible. Then it is imperfect. I have given this example many times that a child learns from his father. The child asks the father, "Father, what is this machine?" And the father says, "My dear child, it is called microphone." So the child receives the knowledge from the father, "This is microphone." So when the child says to somebody else, this is microphone, it is correct. Although he is child, still, because he has received the knowledge from the authority, his expression is correct. Similarly, if he receives knowledge from the authority, then I may be child, but my expression is correct. This is our process of knowledge. We do not manufacture knowledge. That is the process given in the Bhagavad Gita, in the fourth chapter. Evam parampara praptam imang raja rishayogi. This parampara system, imang vivasati yogam bhaktavar ahavam vayam vivasana manavipratu manu khata vidbravi evam parampara. So, absolute knowledge can be achieved when we hear from the Absolute. No person in the relative world can inform us about the Absolute knowledge. That is not possible. So, here we are understanding about the Absolute world, Absolute knowledge from the Supreme Person. The Absolute Person. Absolute Person means Anadi, Adi, Govindi. He is the original person, but he has no origin. Therefore absolute. He is not to be understood being caused by somebody else. That is God. So here, in this chapter, therefore, it is said, Sri Bhagavan was an absolute person. Bhagavan means the absolute person who does not depend on anyone else. So, Krishna said, Maya Satya Manapartha Yogam Jinjana Madhasraya Asang Sayang Samantarang Man Dathakya Sasi Tatsuno. Throughout the whole world, of course, in the human society, advanced human society, alien society, there is a search after God, the Absolute. And the human life is meant for that purpose. Human life is not meant for wasting like dogs and hogs. The dogs and hogs, they are busy all their life to find out where is food, where is food. But the human life is not meant for that purpose. The dogs and the hogs, they do not know that food is supplied by God. Everyone. That is basic information. Eko jo bahunam nidadati kama. God is supplying food to everyone. Therefore the Christian may thought, it is prayed, O God, give us our Gopala, give us our daily bread. That is a very good idea. And even if you do not ask, the food is there. We should understand. Because the animals, lower than human beings, they do not go to church or to temple to ask for daily bread. But they get their bread. The elephants, they eat at a time 40 kg in this African forest, and they are getting their daily food twice. And the ant, if he satisfied with one grain, it is also supplied food. There are 8,400,000 forms of living entities. They are all getting their food without going to the church or to the mosque or praying to the mosque. So actually, to approach God does not mean that we shall ask Him for our bread. Bread He is supplying. You ask or do not ask. The arrangement is there. Therefore, the Bhagavad says, the Saiva Hirita Prajati, whom anyone who is expert, he should try to achieve that thing. The Saiva Hirita Prajati, the Kovita Nanabhati, the Brahmadam Parijana. We have, or we are, wondering. Upari adha. Upari means up, and adha means down. There are higher planetary systems, there are lower planetary systems, there are middle planetary systems. That is called three roads, three worlds. So we living entities, according to our different desires and different activities, we are being promoted to the higher, to the lower, or keeping ourselves in the middle. This is going on perpetually. But we are not getting information what is the aim of life. Therefore, Shastra says that we have traveled so many times, not only once, life after life, in so many forms of life, in so many different planets. But still, we haven't got the information what is the aim of life. Just simply changing one body to another and searching after something, happiness. But we have not received it, simply we are wondering. So, in this human form of life, we should try to achieve that thing which we did not get wandering so many times throughout the whole universe. Tasvaiva eva prajati eva kovida naram bhatejana bhramadam parajadha. Then one may question, if I simply try to achieve Krishna consciousness, then how my baby problem will be solved. The answer is tallabhati dukkha bhagar natasukham. It is according to Vedic Indian science, you are destined to achieve a certain amount of happiness and certain amount of distress also, because you cannot achieve here in this material world any happiness which is not disturbed, that must be distress. So there are two things, happiness and distress. So as you are getting distress without inviting it, nobody invites distress. Let distress come upon me. Nobody invites. But it comes. Similarly, even if you do not pray for happiness, whatever is destined to you, it will come. So don't bother yourself about the material distress and happiness. Try to achieve Krishna consciousness, which you could not achieve in so many lives after life. That is called absolute knowledge. So that Krishna consciousness achievement, how it can be obtained, is being explained by Krishna Himself. Therefore He said, Sri Bhagavan Vaj, the Supreme Personality. Bhagavan means He does not cheat you. Others they will give you instruction and cheat you. Because anyone who is not liberated, he has got four defects of his life. He commits mistakes, he is illusion, he cheats, and his senses are imperfect. This is called conditioned soul, everyone. Even big men, big leaders, they commit so many mistakes. And so far as illusion is concerned, everyone is illusion, because I am not this body, but everyone is thinking I am this body. This is called illusion. Dehātma buddhi. I am not this body. I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. But I am thinking I am Indian, I am American, I am South African, I am black, I am white, I am fat, I am thin. This is body. This is called illusion. And we invent our ideologies by mental speculation without having perfect knowledge. We are accustomed to say, I think what I am. All my senses are imperfect. I commit mistake. I am illusion. And when I say, I think, what is the use of my thinking? This is cheating. So, any conditions, there are two kinds of living entities, the liberated and the conditioned. So we should not receive any knowledge from conditioned person. We must receive knowledge from the liberated. So, Krishna, Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead, who can be more liberated than himself? Therefore, he says, we should accept it. If you are fortunate enough, then whatever he says, we should accept it. He says that, maya sakta mana prattha, yogam yunjana madasa. Everyone, at least human being, advanced human being. The advanced human being is called alien. Means advanced. Anyone who is advanced in spiritual knowledge, he is to be called alien. So the alien civilization, Vedic civilization, when Arjuna denied to fight, Krishna accused him that you are talking like non-aliens. You are not alien. Anarjudustam, anar akutti karamarjuna. You are talking like a non-alien and he should defend your reputation. Don't say like that. So, alien means one who is advanced in spiritual knowledge. So, Krishna says that if you increase your attachment for me, mayi asakta means attachment. Simply if you increase your attachment for me, maya sattva mana, in such mind, that is called actually meditation. The mind is always absorbed in Krishna consciousness. That is meditation. Dhyanavasthita tadagatena manasa pasyanti yam yogi. Yogis, real yogis, not this gymnastic yogi. The real yogi, they dhyanavastita, they always meditate upon Krishna. Dhyanavastita tadagatena manasa by the mind. Dhyanavastita tadagatena manasa. Jana pasanti yogina. Pasanti means he sees, actually sees Krishna. This kind of yoga can be attained if we increase our attachment for Krishna. Maya sakta mana prattha yoga. This is yoga, real yoga. Maya sakta mana prattha yoga jinjana. Madasa. One should take shelter of Krishna or shelter of a person who has taken shelter of Krishna. One who has taken shelter of me or directly. So directly it is not possible because Arjuna was fortunate enough that he contacted Krishna directly. Krishna instructed him directly. So it is not possible for everyone. But if we take the shelter of a person Who has taken shelter of Krishna? That is also Parvati. That is Karamaya Sattva Malam Prapam Yoga Munyan Madas. This is perfect yoga. In the sixth chapter, it is also said that Krishna said, Yoginamati Sarvesham. There are different kinds of yogis, but of all yogis, Yoginamati Sarvesham, Madhavata Antaratma. One who is thinking of me, Krishna. Madhavata Antaratma. Antaratma within the core of heart, he is thinking of Krishna. So, Yoginamati Sarvesham, Madhavata Antaratma. Saddhavan. Saddhavan means with faith. Bhajate, worship me. Same Vipratam, he is first class yogi. He is yogi. So this Krishna consciousness movement is teaching people how to become first class yogi. Same Vipratam. Yogam jinyana malasya. This is real yogi. To practice yoga. Yoga means connection. Yoga in India, yoga means addition. And vyoga means subtract. Vyoga. So we are now vyoga without any contact with the Supreme Lord, personality of God, material condition life. Therefore, we have to make connection with it. That is called yoga. Yoga system means to connect ourselves again with God or Krishna. So this practice of yoga, maya saptamana prapta, always thinking of Krishna. So this process is very easily accomplished by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. If you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, 24 hours, it can be practiced. There is no expenditure, there is no loss, but the gain is very great. We are teaching that we are known as Hare Krishna people, all over the world. It is inexpensive without any loss. If there is a very great gain, why don't you take it? You are not paying any price. You are soliciting everyone. Please chant for it. So it is open. There is no secrecy. You can take it and see by chanting Hare Krishna what gain you are gaining. It is practical. It is not to be asked anymore what I am gaining. It is said, bhakti parasana bhava virakti annatrasya. Bhakti, this is devotional service, chanting. Hare Krishna Mahamantra means the beginning of devotional life, the beginning of liberation. Simply chanting Hare Krishna. So, this is bhakti. There are 9 different processes for executing devotional service. The first thing is savanam. Savanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam padasevanam archanam vandanam dasam satam aapan jivanam. So, you can execute the 9 different processes if possible. If not, you execute 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, at least 1. Then you will be perfect. So, this one, simply chant it and hear it. If you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, you hear it. This process of yoga is recommended in this age. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam. Kalo nāsteva, nāsteva, nāsteva. In the Kali Yuga, it is not possible to practice any other system of yoga. Mind is so agitated, you cannot concentrate. But if you chant loudly Hare Krishna, your mind will be forced to be drawn and hear Krishna. Then maya sakta malam prabha yogam yajnan malha. If you practice this, then asam sayam samadrangma jatha gasati tachino. If you try to hear me attentively, Bhagavan was, who is speaking? Bhagavan, the Supreme Person, the Absolute Person. There is no mistake, there is no cheating, there is no imperfection, and there is no use. It is perfect. So, if we follow, you follow me to increase your attachment for Krishna. We have got attachment. What is attachment? That is not to be learned. Everyone has got attachment. Either he has got attachment for family, or for society, or for community, or for the country, for the nation, and so on his business, at least for his job. So, attachment varies. Everyone can understand what is attachment. But this attachment should be turned over for Krishna. Then your life will be successful. This is explained here. Maya sakta mana prartham yogam yajnana malasam. And if you simply turn your attachment to Krishna, you know what is attachment, then I shall have to give up attachment for my family, for my business. No. We keep this central attachment in Krishna and do whatever you are doing. That's all. Just like family. So, it does not mean because you have turned your attachment, therefore your family attachment should be withdrawn. No. It will be polished. The family attachment will be polished. If you train your family in Krishna consciousness, just early in the morning, rise up, you can control your family in that way. Now, get up, take your bath, have Mangalaruti, then chant Hare Krishna, read Bhagavad Gita, then take prasadam, then go to office or work. So, in this way, if your mind is in Krishna, and if you act accordingly, then there is perfection. Sthane sthita sudhigatam tanumanovi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended this process, that you stay in your position. There is no question of changing your position. But from that position, you become Krishna conscious. And the easiest process is chant Hare Krishna. That is not at all difficult, provided we agree to accept it. Then we can gradually understand what is God, what I am, what is my relationship with God, and so on, everything will be clear. Everything will be clear means, for the time being, our heart is very dark. We are always full of so many dirty consciousness. It has to be cleansed. This cleansing process is this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamudra. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Chetadarpana Marjanam. This Hare Krishna Mahamantra means the first business is to cleanse the dirty heart. The dirty heart means Rajastama. There are three qualities, three modes of material nature. Tamagun, Rajagun, Satagun. So, generally, we are in Rajastamagun, ignorance and passion. The ignorance and passion, the symptom is greediness and lusty desires. So, this is the dirty things. We have to just clings these dirty things, greediness and lusty desires. Then we come to the platform of goodness. And in goodness, we can see things as they are. Therefore, the Krishna consciousness movement means trying the devotees, the followers, to bring him to the platform of goodness, not to stay in the platform of ignorance and bad. That will not help us. Therefore, we recommend his joining Krishna consciousness movement, that he should give up this habit. Initiate sex, intoxication, gambling and music. These four things will keep me in the lower status of life, and it will not allow me to advance in spiritual understanding. Therefore, these things should be given up. And chant Hare Krishna mantra, minimum 16 times. In this way, we see practically these European, American boys and girls. They are improving. They are not material attached. They do not go anywhere. They are always keeping the temple, chant Hare Krishna mantra, busy in Krishna service from morning 3 o'clock, early in the morning, up to 10 o'clock. And they are also young men. They must have desire. But bhakti parikhana, bhakti anmatrasya. Bhakti is so nice that now they hate any other engagement. These illicit sex, meeting, and intoxication and gambling, they hate. You bring them, lack of rupee, they will not get it. Virakti anmatrasya, this is the taste of bhakti. Detachment from all these nonsense things. And unless you are purified, you cannot understand God. That is our own only business in the human life. To understand God, we have no other needs. And if you want to understand God, then you have to become purified. Without being purified, Visham tu antagatam papam jananam punna karmanam te ganga mahanirmukta bhajanti mahanirmukta. So it is very easy thing. Simply, we have to take to this yoga system, yoga jnana pada, under the shelter of Krishna or his devotee. Then we shall understand what is God in full samagram. Samagram means full, without any doubt. Other mental speculators, they are in doubt. They do not know whether there is God, or what kind of God he is, what does he do, or what is his business. There are so many things. But these Krishna conscious people, they know exactly what is God, where is his address, where is his family, everything they know. Samagram. Samagram and asamusa, without any doubt. Not that, yes, I have now come to know God, where he lives, his address and his activity. But it may not be. So it is not difficult. If we actually serious to understand what is God, God is explaining here himself. He cannot speculate upon God. God is explaining himself. This is, I am like this. Just like a very big man. If you speculate upon him, he may be possessing so much wealth, he may be like this. No. That may be or may not be. But if that person explains himself, my dear Mr. Such and Sir, my position is like this, and like this, and then it is very easy. So take instruction from God to understand God. Then your life will be fine. And if you understand God, then your all problems solved. Our real problem is repetition of birth and death. That is real problem. That we do not know. We are careless. We do not know what is the position of my real self. That we do not know. This is called ignorance. That instruction is given in the Bhagavad Gita in the beginning. Nahanate hannamane sarire. This living spirit. Na jayate nam yate va kadachi. Nahanate hannamane sarire. This spirit soul is never born. Then what is this birth? The birth is of this body. Vehinas means the Vehi Kumara. This change of body. We are changing body. But I am the eternal. I know that I had a body of the child. This body is gone. The childhood body no more existed. But I know that I had a body. This is the proof that I am eternal. The body is changed. This is, I was a young man, now I am old man. But I know I was a young man, my body was like this, I was doing that. But now that is not possible. Because that body has gone. So similarly, the conclusion is that when this body will be vanquished, I shall accept another body. Tatha dehantara prakti. This is simple method of understanding the transmigration of the soul. So real problem is that I am eternal, but I am put into such condition that I have to take birth and die, I have to become old and I have to disease. This is the real problem. The modern civilization, they are supposed to be very much advanced. What is advancement? The real problem is that you have to accept death. Nobody wants to die. But why death is there? But they are careless. They think we have to accept this death. Or this is finished. All vague idea. No real idea. So, if we want to be really learning, if we want to know what is our constitutional cohesion? What is the aim of life? What is God? How we can re-establish our relationship with God? These things are explained in the Bhagavad Gita very clearly. And if we are intelligent enough, we should take this Krishna consciousness movement very seriously. And if you want to understand this movement scientifically, philosophically, we have got hundreds of books, all being accepted by educated circles, very logically and very philosophically written. You read them, chant Hare Krishna, take advantage of this movement and be successful in your life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Any question?
Your sister has a question. Can you come up to the front and speak to the microphone? I guess you know.
The question is that man knows right from wrong because of his karma.
No. Karma, maybe, just like you are sent to school, college, to understand the right and wrong. Therefore, you must be educated to know what is right and wrong. Not that you do right anyways, whatever you like. That is, education required, because we have no education. Therefore, there are so many books of knowledge, basic knowledge. You have to take advantage of it and then you understand what is right and wrong. Otherwise, no.
According to the present situation here in Karnataka,
you can take advantage.
Man has a very high intelligence, when he's educated, the word ethical or something is to read or something in Latin. But the question is, much of the African people here are not educated, deprived of their education. They look upon a man of intelligence or guidance.
Real education is, first of all, you must know what you are. You are this body or something else than the body. Just like when a man dies, his son or relative laments, "Oh, my father has gone." Now, father is lying there on the bed. Why do you say, "My father has gone"? The father is lying on the bed. Therefore, you did not see who is your father. After that, you are realizing that your father is gone. Then where is your education? You cannot see in your father, then where is your education? This is no education. Therefore you must know what I am, what is my father, what is my mother. That is real education.
From Lord Krishna to Arjuna, can Swami please explain how it is that Sanjaya is raising to Dhritarashtra and how it came to pass that Vyasadeva wrote the Bhagavad Gita?
It is like my television nowadays. You can see things happening thousands of miles away in television, and you can explain to your friends, this is like that. It is a question of seeing power. So now we have got this instrument, television machine, which is not difficult to understand. In the football ground, the match is going on, and it is being relayed in your room. It is that. Consciousness movement is to educate people on the principles of the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. So if you understand Bhagavad Gita thoroughly, then you'll understand Lord Rama also, and other incarnations, because Krishna is present with all the incarnations. Rama Vimurti Sukalam Yamena Tishtan Nana Votaram Tadat Prabhu Sukhintu Krishna Sam Samabhavat Paramasumana Ju Govindam Adivindam Samabhavat. In the Vedic literature it is said, Jasmin Vijnate Savamilam Vijnatam Bhavanti. He who understands that one supreme, then you will understand everything. So, Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana, not other Ramayana, the so-called Ramayana, authority, Valmiki Ramayana. If you read Valmiki Ramayana, that is also as good as reading Bhagavad Gita. But if you read Bhagavad Gita, you understand the transcendental science very easily. There is no difficulty. So we shall advise to read Bhagavad Gita. It is very widely read all over the world, not only by the Hindus, but others also, by all scholars, all philosophers, they read Bhagavad Gita. So we recommend you all to read Bhagavad Gita as it is. Do not distort the meaning. Try to understand as it is. Just like in the beginning, the Bhagavad Gita is mentioned. Dharma Kshetri, Kuru Kshetri, Samabhita, Vidutsava, Manva, Mamaka, Pandava, Silva, King Apurva Prasanya. Dharma Kshetri, Kuru Kshetri. This is a fact. The Kuru Kshetra is a pilgrimage. Dharma Kshetri, still it is. There is a railway station of the name Kurukshetra, and the Kurukshetra place is very big field. So why should we misinterpret Kurukshetra means this body and Pandava means the senses? Why? This business distorting the meaning should give up. We should understand as it is. Kurukshetra is there, it is a pilgrimage, and every past history, 5,000 years ago, two sections of the same family, Kuru family, one section was known as Pandava, and the other section was Kuru. They had to fight on political reasons. This is historical. So there is no question of misinterpreting it. The difficulty is, as soon as we misinterpret to our needs, to show our scholarship, it is spoiled. Don't do that. Read it as it is, and you will get the benefit.
Yes?
Swami, we are living in a world where new thoughts, new ideas are being seen, disseminated, okay, by saintly people. But as we have read, the Veda, the first book of knowledge handed to mankind. Now what I would like to know is, the Christians have Bible as the book. The Muslims have the Quran as the book. And the Hindus have the Vedas as the book. Why should we not go back to the Vedas rather than accepting, not that I mean accepted many other scriptures, the Bhagavad Gita or the Ramayana, but they say the four sheep who were first created and Vedas were given to us at the beginning of God's creation. Why don't we go back to the Vedas? And then
we know that
there is
a difference. So, what is the purpose of reading Veda? Can you say? Who can say? What is the purpose of reading Veda? That is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. Vivishta sarvai ahami yogijyam. By reading Vedas, any Veda, you have to understand God. Then it is perfect reading of Veda. If you do not understand what is God, then what is the use of reading Veda? Samaya vahikeva, simply waste of time. If you have read Veda, then give me full information of God. Then I can understand that you have read Veda. If you have no idea of God, then it is useless advertisement that I have read Vedas.
Swami, most of our Hindus, except Lord Krishna, has also been as a God.
Yet in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna doesn't want to fight his brothers. Lord Krishna encourages to fight his own brothers, to kill his own brothers, to shed blood. Isn't this condoning violence? Yet Hinduism doesn't condone violence. Can you explain why Lord Krishna encourages Arjuna to fight his own blood?
If you can question the High Court judge, why he is ordering somebody to be hanged, then what will be the answer? The High Court judge orders somebody to be hanged and somebody to take degree for 1 lakh of rupees. Is there injustice? It is the law. The Supreme Lord has to execute the law. So, there is no mistake. As there is no mistake in the judgment of the High Court, similarly, what to speak of Krishna, the Supreme Lord? There is necessity, the government, in order to keep law and order. There is violence also, the police sometimes commit violence, the military force. So, in order to keep the whole thing in balance, sometimes violence is required. That is not to our means, but at the decision of the Supreme Law.
There is a school of thought among the Hindus that condemn idol worship and the concept of Allah. Can you kindly elaborate on these concepts?
Idol worship, that is not idol. Just like if you worship your leader in some picture or some statue, that is not idol worship. That is actually fact. You show your respect to your leader. Similarly, when you worship the deity of the Supreme Lord, Krishna, it is not idol worship, it is worshipping Krishna. The difference is, as we have already discussed, Krishna is absolute. In the ordinary case, the picture of your father and the father is different because it is material body. But Krishna, being absolute, he is form, deity form, and he, there is no difference. It is Krishna's mercy that he comes before you in the deity form, made of so-called wood or stone, because we cannot see at the present moment except wood and stone. We cannot see. Just like I was explaining, we cannot see in our father, the spirit soul. And how we can see the Supreme Spirit? So when we worship deity, it is not idol worship, it is worshipping Lord Krishna, and the deity is not different from the person. This is it. We have to understand it is a science. Just like the holy name of the Lord, it is as good as the Lord Himself. Nama Sundamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasavidya Purna Shuddha Nitya Mukta Abhinna Vyad Nama Nama. When you chant Hare Krishna, this means Krishna is dancing on my tongue. Otherwise, why these people are chanting 24 hours Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna? If you ask them to chant some other name, Mr. John, Mr. John, Mr. John, it will be not good. He will be tired, no more. But you go on chanting Hare Krishna 24 hours, you'll never be tired. That is the proof that the holy name of God and God is loving. He has already explained the idol, it is not idol, it is Krishna. Krishna is all powerful. He can present himself in a manner which you can see. Because Krishna is everything. Bhumi Rabana Rabal Khanamana Buddhi. He is everything. God is everything. So you cannot see at your present status the God. But he can see his form, and the business will be done. If you offer everything, Krishna will eat, the business is gone. There is no difference. It is his mercy that he presents himself in a form which we can see.
But from where did we come? Why are we here? And where are we going?
Where from? Just now we are coming. Tell me, where from you are coming? You cannot say? Who can say where from he is coming? Where from you are coming? You cannot say? You cannot say what form you are coming just now?
That is what I would like to know.
Now, first of all, say,
what is the true reason for our existence? And where are we going?
You are coming from home.
I want to say,
so, this is our temporary home. We have got real home. That is the kingdom of God. We are coming from there. That's why you have come from India. Your forefathers have come from India. Now you have made this country as your home. Similarly, we have come from the spiritual world. Now we have made this material world as our home. So here, struggling for existence. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Mamaivamsa-jiva-bhuta jiva-rupa-sanātana manas-sasthāni-indriyāni-pakriti-sthāni-karsati. These living entities, they are mine, part and parcel. Or they are as good as I am. Part and parcel, a small particle of gold. It is not a thing. Similarly, we being part and parcel of God, we are also the same quality, not the same quantity, but same quality. So we have come here and we are struggling for existence with our mind and senses. This is our position. Therefore, our business is how to go back to home, back to God. That is our main business. We are teaching them. All right, chant Hare Krishna. Please join chanting Hare Krishna.